a PhD in cellular molecular biology and a background in proteomics, which is essentially protein analysis. I was studying how to manipulate and analyze proteins to help make ovarian cancer patients resusceptible to chemotherapy agents, which is a pretty cool job. In my last year of grad school, I started my family. And I don't know that I would recommend that for other people. We had our oldest daughter and she had awful colic. She screamed all of the time, all days, all night, for weeks. We took her in and said, okay, something's wrong. She is inconsolable. And we were told, yeah, that's your baby. Good luck with that. High five, and sent home. A few weeks went by and we woke up to find her one morning completely covered in eczema from head to toe with a massively bloody diaper. As a new parent, it was absolutely terrifying. My husband has ulcerative colitis, so of course, as a new mom, my mind went to all of the most awful places. We took her back in and said, oh, okay, now we definitely broke her. What do we do next? What is wrong with our child? At that point, we were told, maybe consider removing cow's milk protein from your diet. She might be reacting to something that you're eating. My mind was blown. That was the first time, even as a new mom who is breastfeeding and studies proteins for a living, that I had ever heard that I could transfer something to my breast milk from my diet. I did exactly that. I removed cow's milk protein from my diet and continued breastfeeding, and our daughter spiraled. She got very worse very quickly. We were eventually admitted to the hospital, and they said that she had a severe food protein allergy and could not tell us what it was to. I ended up removing many things from my diet to continue breastfeeding her, and it was a really, really hard year for our family. When our second daughter was born with the exact same problem, I was absolutely terrified to go through all of that all over again. In all of the irony in the world, I happened to also be working for a dairy processing facility. I was literally making millions of pounds of the food that I could not consume while breastfeeding. In the midst of that, postpartum, breastfeeding, allergen-free, I was teaching lab techs how to test cow's milk for the presence of other allergens. There's a very simple test that we can use in the lab in order to ensure that we didn't accidentally cross-contact cow's milk products with like egg products, for example. And this test is very, very simple. And I had an epiphany. What would happen if I snuck into a closet and squirted some breast milk on this thing? I would love to know if there was egg in my breast milk. Free to Feed helps parents navigate infant food allergies. Our technology will allow parents to test their breast milk for the presence of allergens at home in order to determine what's eliciting a response for their infant. They'll then be able to test subsequent milk for those proteins and previously pumped milk at home. Our research and subsequent intellectual property is all focused on how can we properly test breast milk for allergens. The three most important pieces are, one, what does a protein look like after it enters mom's breast milk? A peanut doesn't look like a peanut any longer once it's traveled from your gastrointestinal system through the circulatory system and then entered your breast. Two, what does actually elicit a response in infants? So what portions of that peanut that now transfers cause issues for infants? And three, what can we test for that won't cross react with proteins that already naturally exist in human milk? These are the things that are so important for this space and is a massive part of our platform, our research, and our patent. The other vital part of our mission is to provide parents with the support through early and often introduction as recommended by the American Association for Pediatrics. What's interesting today is that now we know through research that early and often introduction can be beneficial for certain proteins. Now, actually supporting parents through that is a whole nother journey. And while we did change the recommendation for the introduction of those proteins, there was very little true support for parents in how to navigate that change. It's easy to say, don't introduce peanuts for the first 3 years of life. It's a lot more difficult to say, actually, It turns out that the research indicates that we should early and often introduce peanuts in the early months of life. By giving parents the ability to test their breast milk for the presence of allergens at home, we're also giving them the ability to early and often introduce proteins such as peanuts and eggs on day one, as opposed to month four or month six, which we believe will have a massive impact on the research realm of immunology, as well as significantly reduce the prevalence of peanut and egg allergies for future generations. Yeah, so I would have to say that Peter, my husband, has supported everything about Free to Feed from its inception, from day one of us having our oldest daughter who had food allergies to today. When I first thought of the idea of Free to Feed, it was just this little conception, and we were just barely had our second daughter, just started our food journey with her, an elimination diet journey with her, and I remember sitting on the couch with him one night and was like, what if we could test breast milk and just know what was in my breast at any given moment? Like, what if we could do that? And he was like, that's amazing. You have to do that. That's a thing you can do. And so then I was like, well, what would we call it? And so we started talking about like the dream behind Free to Feed. And I told him in the moment, I was literally breastfeeding our second daughter, allergen-free diet, breastfeeding her, and I was like, I just want to have the freedom to breastfeed. Like, I just want to be free to feed. And he was like, well, there it is, it's Free to Feed. And he just took off with it. He made the milk drop that has a nipple on it. That man put that nipple on Free to Feed's logo, and he is incredibly proud of it. That is probably like the epitome of his career. My favorite thing about Free to Feed is the number of families and parents that we have already impacted. So even though our testing isn't yet available on the market, we have impacted thousands of families, and I get to hear every single day from parents, moms, and dads who reach out to me and say like, oh my gosh, it's my son's first birthday. I'm so amazed that we got to breastfeed to a year old, and it's all because of you and your content and the help that you provided and the personalization that you provided. And that literally keeps me getting up every single morning and doing this crazy journey all over again. So hearing from parents is my favorite thing about Free to Feed. And my favorite thing about the Indie Bio program has been having the community of entrepreneurs who are very much like me in that scientist or science-minded who are trying to build a company. So where you can feel very much alone in that, in a lot of other entrepreneurial spaces, you're not surrounded by a bunch of other scientists. So to have other people who have very similar mindsets as I do, and also very similar struggles, I think is really impactful. If you are navigating infant food allergies, or would like to learn more information about our organization, click the link below.